Hello friends, welcome to SQL Training session. This is Samantha Rajput and today we'll learn what is SQL, what is select into command in SQL Server, how we can use the select asterisk into command in SQL Server. So basically this command is used for to copy the records from one table to another table. So basically it is used to copy data from one table the table, okay, and this is also used to create a schema, create a new table with same schema from another table. When I say schema, it means the table structure. So select as, into command is also used to create a new table with the same schema what we have from the another table. So I'll give you an example to demonstrate it. So I have logged into my SSMS and in this you can see here I have a database, Adventure Walk 2014 database. So let me drag one table from Adventure Walk's database. Let me drag a table here, department in Adventure Work database. If I execute, I can see here I have plenty of records here. How many records? I have 16 records. You can go and check 16 rows affected. So I have a 16 records. Let's suppose we have a requirement to copy the data of this table, department table, to another table, to another new table. So how we can do that? We can help with the help of select into, we can achieve the same. How the syntax would be like select asterisk into, and we need to pass the new table here. Let's suppose I name it as department new table. Okay, if you can see here, I do not have any table with this name, department new table. If you can see here, I do not have any table. So what this command will do, select asterisk, it will first create the table with this name, department new table, with the schema or with the same structure what we have in department table. And second thing it will do, it will copy all the record from department table to newly created table, because we have used the asterisk. Asterisk will pick all the columns data. So let me execute and we'll show you how it will turn. Let me execute. See, 16 row affected. It is the SQL Server gives us a message, 16 row affected. That means the new table has been created and all the 16 record from department table is moved to department new table in AdventureWorks database. If you want to verify, you just go here and refresh the tables in AdventureWorks and you will be able to see the new table, department new table, has been created. If you want to verify whether all the records are inserted into this table or not, all you need to do is use the select asterisk from this table. You can see here all the columns data will be moved into this table. Now if this is the one thing what this command will do, and another thing, if you do not want to move all the columns data, if you want to move only name column and group name columns data into this table, department new data, so how we can do this? All we need to do is we need to just mention, instead of asterisk, we need to mention the column names, name and group name. We need to mention this two columns. So what it will do, it will create the table and it will create the table and move only the data which is having only the data from these two columns into department new table. Before executing this, let me drop this table first, because this table is already been created, so this query will fail. because this select command select into command is also used to create a new table, as we already have a table, so it will throw us an error. So for a safer side, we'll drop first this table, drop table, and we'll recreate it through this first statement. Let me drop this table. Now the table doesn't exist. Let us check it. See the table, we do not have a table. Let me go and again execute this. When we execute this statement, the new table will be created. 16 rows will be inserted into this table. But this time, what will happen? If we refresh the table, see the new table is inserted, department new table. If I fetch the records from, we can see only the two columns, names and group name, is been copied. Not all the four columns is been copied from department table. Okay. Now there is also one thing. If you want to only create a table, you do not need to copy the data. That means if we want to create a table which is having the same structure as department table, but we do not move the data of the department table to department new table. So in that case, what we need to do? First, we need to drop this table. Now in that case, we do not need to copy the copy. So in that case, we need to give the where clause, 1 equal to 1, 1 equal to 0, which is the first statement, and this will enable us to create the table, department new table, with the same structure as department, but it doesn't allow us to copy the records from department. So let me execute and I will show you. See, zero row affected. That means the structure has been created, but no row has been moved from department table. Let me refresh and we'll show you. This is the department new table has been created. If I go and select, we'll see we have only two columns. Okay, we have two columns. Why? Because we have mentioned the column's name. If I would have used the extra here, then all the four columns would be here. Okay, and you can see there is no records in this table. So what happened? This command will create a table, and then we'll create a table with these two columns. As we have used where equal to 1 equal to 0, that means the copy will not happen as it is a false statement. Okay, so in this case, we can use the select into command in SQL Server. Okay, there is one more use of this command. If you want to create this new table in another database, as of now, I have given you an example in which I have created a new table in the same database, in AdventureWalk database. Let's suppose I have another table database, MegastoreDB. If I want to copy the records, let me delete this. Want to copy the record of department table from AdventureWalk database to new table, department new table, okay, in MegastoreDB. So in that case, all you need to do, you need to provide the fully qualified name of your new table. Let me select as true. If I expand this DBN, there is no table as of now, department new table. We do not have a department new table. If you can see here, we have a department new, but we do not have department new table as of now in MegastoreDB. Okay, so I need to provide the fully qualified name. Fully qualified name means database dot schema name, then table name. Okay, this is the fully qualified name of the data of the table. Now I'll go and execute this statement. What it is giving us message that 16 row affected. That means 16 row is been moved from department table in AdventureWalk database, which is exist in Adventure database, to department new table, which is just created in MegastoreDB database. So let me refresh the tables in MegastoreDB. Here you can see new department new table has been created, and if I check how many records is inserted, you can see here 16 record, and the same 16 record is been copied to this table. So in this way, you can use the select into command in SQL Server database. Again, if you want to create the same, again if you want to copy the same 16 records into the same table, so what it does, it will give us an error that there is an already an object named department new table in the database. So basically this select into will do two things. First, it will create a new table with the same schema, and then it will copy the data from one table. So again, if you want to copy the data, first you need to drop the table, and then you will be able to copy the records from source table to destination table, you can say. Hope you like the video. Thank you so much.